very much. We have some breaking news to get to before we had to break. The Justice Department announced just a minute ago that there's a federal grand jury has indicted former Trump advisor Steve Bannon and charged him with contempt of Congress. This after Steve Bannon refused a subpoena from the White House committee investigating January 6th. And earlier today, we heard from that former chief of staff. Mark Meadows also did not appear after he was subpoenaed. We expect him to be charged as well. More on all of that as information comes in. Okay, so we brought some breaking news to you earlier. Steve Bannon has been indicted by a federal grand jury, but also there's a warrant out for his arrest. And we wanted to bring in someone who has a good idea of what's going on here. Bridget Gabriel, she's a chairman of ActForAmerica.org. Bridget, this is breaking news as we speak, as we came to air. Drudge Head is a little one of those four-alarm fire things circling. So what are your thoughts on the way the Justice Department is going after Bannon and the others in the Trump administration, former?
Well, let's just say there is no justice anymore in the Justice Department, because right now the Justice Department has been weaponized against the Trump team and against conservatives, and they are going after witch hunts, trying to hunt down leaders who are involved with the president, people who are close within his inner circles, and they are targeting them. And this is why this whole charade, this whole window dressing is basically going after them to get them. It'll be very interesting to see what's going to happen in this case, and whether they arrest him or when they arrest him, and how this is going to proceed. This is not right. Something is so wrong in our government when our government agencies are weaponized against people simply because of their political belief. But that's the America we live in right now.
It's unbelievable. To put out a warrant for Bannon's arrest, I mean, I know they asked him to come in, they subpoenaed him, and he said no. But these are the way things work. You can go through the legal channels. I mean, he's not accused of a crime at this point, I do believe. Am I getting this right?
No, I don't believe he's accused of any crime. But look, he did not commit any crime. I mean, what was his crime? Why are they going after him? Why are they arresting him? But I hope that Steve Bannon has top-notch attorneys right now who are fighting for him. And again, the whole nation is going to be watching, or at least the conservatives are going to be watching how this case is going to transpire. Because this is going to affect every American. Right now, the government is arresting people, throwing them in jail. They're not giving them attorneys. I mean, look at the January 6th people. A lot of people don't even know what's happening to them. They're not being heard. They're not. It's like people in Cuba, people in Gitmo has more rights than the January 6th prisoners. So this is going to be very interesting. Our government is like communist China right now. People are being arrested without a crime. People are being charged. People are being thrown in jail without rights to an attorney or an appeal or knowing what's happening with them. The Americans need to wake up and realize that they better get involved, and get involved in grassroots, get involved locally with their elections, get involved with their elected officials, because this, we are at a time where we may be the people trying to protect themselves from a corrupt and a totalitarian government. We never thought that will happen in America, but it looks like this is the direction where our country is going.
It's unbelievable, Bridget Gabriel. It's just unbelievable where American citizens are being held in solitary at sometimes 23 out of 24 hours a day here in America. But terrorists can go to Gitmo and get soccer fields built for them and vending machines put up so they have a good and internet and make sure they're okay. They're terrorists. They're trying to kill us.
That's right.
But we have people who are not even convicted of anything sitting behind bars and sometimes in the conditions that you outlined. Very quickly, final thought, Bridget.
Exactly. And not allowed medical treatment. I mean, look, we already had somebody that died. At least prisoners in Gitmo were allowed dental and eye exams. I mean, They had their teeth fixed. Well, they couldn't even fix them in Afghanistan and in the areas where we arrested them. It is a shameful day in our country. And again, I encourage the grassroots time to wake up and become engaged. Go to ActForAmerica.org and get involved.
Get involved. Bridget Gabriel, thank you so much for your time.